when we talk about these issues of security and safety, I know it can be scary for the kids, and sometimes we think about it from the adult perspective and we forget about what the kids are thinking and feeling.
School violence is nothing new, and we've brought story after story to you over the years, and we've seen positive changes like securing entrances to buildings.
But with a growing concern of student safety being threatened both inside and outside the classroom, officials are meeting with parents and students tonight here in Fargo to try to bring fresh solutions to the table.
Valley News Team's Rose Itzkovitz has more on what will be discussed tonight and what parents want to see happen.
She didn't go to the bathroom at school at all.
Fargo mom Jenny Momsen first noticed something strange when her youngest daughter was in fourth grade.
My daughter would come home from school and she would just rush to the bathroom right away. And I asked her, what's going on here? And she said, well, I don't go to the bathroom at school because if there's an active shooter, I don't want to be caught separated from my classroom. I don't want to be in the bathroom.
Momsen realized then how anxious active shooter drills made her daughter.
Minimize the anxiety and the stress that it puts on kids. I can't imagine what it does to teachers, too, thinking about being responsible for an entire classroom.
Issues like this prompted Fargo Representative Carla Rose Hansen to call a meeting.
We really want to just continue the conversation with our neighbors.
The meeting happening here at the Senior Center on Broadway will get students, parents, and officials together in hopes to bring solutions to the table. The conversation on school safety will feature two large issues.
One is around safe classrooms and student health.
A lot of what my youngest would call naughty behavior, you know, where kids are acting up and acting out.
Fargo Public Schools says the year ended with 777 incidents where staff was injured by students, 31 requiring medical attention.
And the other issue we want to dig into is building security, so making sure that our school buildings are safe from outside threats.
And she's like, they're scary. They're very scary, and I don't like them at all. And they don't seem very helpful in the end, that they're not going to really protect us.
We're told the plan is for this discussion to be the first of more to come. In Fargo, Rose Iskovitz, Valley News Live.
Tonight's meeting is going to be held at the Senior Center on Broadway. It begins at 7 o'clock. And for more on what one school is doing for added security, we invite you to tune in to Valley News Live at 9 on the Fargo CW and on Valley News Live 10 at 10.
We can't seem to shake that wind. Our weather has been plagued by that for days. Let's find out from Justin if there's any relief in sight. He's here now with your No Wait weather. Justin.
And thank you, Andrea and Mike. Good evening, everybody. Temperatures with that strong northwesterly wind are cool for this time of year. We should be into the upper 70s. Current temperatures into the mid-60s into Lakes Country's upper 60s to near 70 as you make your way out toward Devil's Lake, Jamestown, and up and down the valley. Here's a look at the winds right now. Winds are starting to die down right now around 15 to 25 miles per hour from the northwest. That trend will continue through this evening. Other than that, we do have mainly clear skies, just a few clouds into the Devil's Lake Basin, most of the moisture missing us well off to the east and off to the north. So through this evening, as soon as we lose the sunshine, temperatures back into the 50s, and they'll continue to fall through the overnight low temperatures near 46 degrees as we have more sunshine in store for the day tomorrow. As temperatures stay a little cool for this time of year, we'll have the details on that and your Labor Day weekend forecast. That's coming up later in the newscast.
All right, thanks, Justin.
A bicyclist was hurt and taken to the hospital this afternoon after colliding with a car. The crash happening near the intersection of 13th Avenue South and 45th Street. No names are released. The injuries, however, were said to be minor.
We have new information on the three women who were arrested after a high-speed chase in Moorhead. The driver is 26-year-old Star Racine from Newtown. She's charged with fleeing police, along with giving false information. One passenger, 30-year-old Charlie Fox, was arrested for outstanding warrants. The third woman was released. The chase started in the 1100 block of 5th Street South and ended near 50th Avenue. Police say the chase was less than 8 minutes in all because they were able to slow the vehicle down with stop sticks.
We now know the name of the human remains found in South Fargo last week. They belong to 32-year-old Brenda Cardis. Police say they believe her death is suspicious and they're treating it as a homicide. Cardis disappeared in July of 2018, last seen leaving a Fargo rehab center. Online, Brenda's friends and family say they want the conversation to stop regarding her addiction.
I don't want her to be remembered as being an addict, because just because you're an addict, it does not make you a terrible person. She was still a good person, still had a big heart. She loved with all of her heart.
Police are asking that if you have any information on this case, you are urged to contact their tip line.
A 71-year-old Lisbon man is facing charges of gross sexual imposition. Ernest Bollinger is in the Cass County Jail. An investigation began after authorities were notified of sexual abuse allegations against Bollinger involving a minor.
Two bikers hit speeds of more than 130 miles per hour during a chase with a North Dakota Highway Patrol officer. It happened near Hillsboro yesterday afternoon. Authorities say Ethan Scherer lost control of his motorcycle while trying to get away and crashed into a ditch. He's been arrested and charged. There was a second driver that got away, so if you have any information on the incident, call the Highway Patrol.
A man is behind bars, suspected of stealing gas and then running from police. The Stutsman County Sheriff's Office says it started around 1 this morning in Jamestown. They say 24-year-old Brett Mears filled his gas tank and then drove off without paying. Deputies say when they found Mears' car, a chase started. It ended about 15 minutes later when Mears drove into a ditch. Now he's facing multiple charges, including theft of services, reckless driving, and fleeing police.
Fire crews were called out to a cooking fire two times in 1 hour today. They happened at an apartment complex along 15th Street North. Smoke filled the building's basement. All of the tenants made it out safely, including a dog that at one point was thought to be trapped inside.
A clogged and backed up sewer canceled classes for students in Oaks today. The superintendent tells us the clog caused sewer gas to spread through the school buildings. So to keep students safe, they were given the day off. Plumbers took care of the clog and windows were opened to let the smell out so that classes will resume tomorrow.
An elementary school program is proving that you're never too old to have a big impact on a child.
Grandparents are heading back to school to help out some of North Dakota's littlest learners. Megan Hoffman has the story.
How's school going this year?
Good. Luther Bell wears many hats at Lincoln Elementary.
Cleaning tables, sweeping floors, helping kids, antagonizing kids, joking with the kids, having a great time.
Bell started volunteering when the school opened 6 years ago, and now the kids refer to him as Grandpa. He's one of four retired volunteers helping the students while they're trying to eat their midday meal.
I've been blessed in so many ways in my lifetime, and I just felt like I needed to give back.
Ron Kinsler helps the students put trays away at the end of the meal, while Ruth Praska goes through wiping up the tables and floors. Both have grandkids in the fifth grade this year.
They're active, they're busy, but they bring you joy every day. I mean, you never know what one of them's gonna say.
Well, the whole thing's coming apart.
They say they were just as excited for that first day as the kids were.
Summer gets to be a long time, and it's neat to get back to school again, just like with the kids, you know, to get back into a routine.
And enjoy watching the students go from kindergarten.
The poor little people didn't even know how to open their milk. I felt so sorry for them.
To the leaders of the school.
It's fun just to see them as they mature and they grow in their skills.
While the volunteers try and help the students along each day the best they can.
Here in our area, several schools have lunch buddy programs if you would like to volunteer. Adults of all ages can come in and spend time with children at lunch.
Later on Valley News Live at 6, there's a way to help teens get more sleep and better grades. But most school districts don't do it. We'll tell you why.
And our average high is 78 degrees. We were only near 70 for the day today with a lot of sunshine. More on the way for the day tomorrow in that all-important Labor Day weekend forecast. That is next.